have a senior project final presentation. My name is Megan Perry, and this is...
I'm Maggie Bailey.
And we are the, we're the facilitators, I would say, for this class. Teachers, it's kind of a stretch, because the senior project class is primarily an independent study class. We have, in the end, we ended up with 9 intrepid seniors from Maynard New Tech who decided to take on the challenge of this unknown thing called the senior project. And the idea was that it's this sort of capstone experience where after spending 4 years at Maynard New Tech learning, through project-based learning, that students would take on an issue that they cared about or a concept that they were interested in studying and design a year-long project that they would do some research but then also implement something to impact the community. So tonight is the first of 3 nights this year where the students will be presenting their projects. So the students we have tonight, Stephen Dominguez is gonna go first, and we have Ricky Hayes and Todd Dow, who are gonna be presenting their projects. So without further ado, Stephen Dominguez.
First of all, good evening. Thank you all for being here. It means so much to me. Personal trainers, gym memberships, sports equipment, soccer cleats, baseball bats, shin guards, and athletic apparel. Ladies and gentlemen, these are all things, products of a concept that I like to call healthy business. My name is Stephen Dominguez, and this is my senior project. Now, it all starts with running. Why running? Why did I need it to be about running? I have a bit of an idea. You know, this is an individual sport. It's not like all the other ones we heard about where there's a team and there's more people involved in some kind of sport. This is a sport that, you know, is based on a single person. And the benefits of running are include a stronger endurance, include cardiovascular and muscular systems, good for the body. Now, of course, I like running because I myself run cross country. I run track, mainly because my mom runs. She ran way back in high school. She was the awesome track star. And of course, my family supports me in running. Secret behind the family, though, my uncle runs because she runs. My aunts pretty much are athletic, and many of my cousins run. So I think it's safe to say that I was meant to run in some way, somewhere in my blood. Running just is in me, being athletic. So I knew I wouldn't need my project to be about running, but what about it? That's where I was stuck. I thought to myself for a while about running and business. I needed it to gear towards my collegiate goals, what I want to pursue in college. I want to get a degree in business as well as dance. So, and I tend to like things, concepts that revolve around money. So, put all 3 together, and I had an idea. We get a 5K. It hit me. Why not build a 5K? This was actually my dream, sort of started at the end of last year, my junior year, in that right when we finished prom, I was bored. I was a senior class president and had a lot to do with prom and the way things went, and when it was over, there was nothing more to raise money for. So I thought about a 5K, why not? The seniors that are already graduating, I want to do something for them. Let's give them a 5K because they're going off to college. I don't know, it was already May, the dream died. But the senior project brought it back alive. So we're gonna leave it at that 5K, that's what I want. This is what I want my senior project final product to be, some kind of 5K for what? I'm not sure yet. So my research began on the economics back to running. They include improvement, of course, in the cardiovascular and muscular systems, which I already said. But I started with a survey of Runner's World magazine, and they surveyed about 2,000 runners on just in general, about anything. And most of the runners said that as an individual sport, running is said to be one of the most easiest ways to stay fit and healthy. Well, I agree as a runner, and I'm sure any of you out there agree as well. But I wanted to know more. I wanted to know, what is the business, the economics behind running? Why is it that I pay $100 or less for a pair of running shoes, and so do other runners, for that every 6 months, because we can't put more than 500 miles on them, something like that. These are for the not just run from here to that door runners, for some of you that are out there, but that's okay too, as long as you're running. I needed to know more. I needed to know what's next. So I started with basic business behind running, the economics, the shoes, right? They range anywhere from $35 to about $145, give or take. What kind of running shoe do you want? It just depends. And that's not even including what runners spend on races like a 5K, which range anywhere from $15 to $35, depending on what it's for, what the cause is, where it's at, what gas you have to pay to get to the race, different things like that. So all in all, the survey concluded that 62% of runners spend between $200 to $1,000 a year on running-related expenses, whether it be races, shoes, goo, apparel, socks, anything, running. And 43% of those runners have increased their running activity since the past year. Now, this survey was taken back in 2009, so they're talking about 2008, you know, maybe the economic crisis that was around that time. So now they're increased their running activities. But what's the economics behind the racing aspect of it? We know that their runners are spending maybe too much than they should on what they need in order to run, but that's okay. That's part of their budget. They've already thought about it. What about racing specifically? I wanted to know the economics of a 5K. What kind of revenue a 5K brings in? How does it bring it in? And what does it need to happen in order to get a 5K done? So my research took a turn to the economics of racing. I found out there are two types of races, for-profit and non-profit. For-profit being usually a fundraiser in order to raise money for an organization or something like that, and non-profit specifically held as some sort of campaign, get the word out of something, you know, a concept, alcohol, drugs, use like that. So we know what kinds of races there are. All right, I'm thinking, what do I need mine to be about? What do I need mine to be about? And then my research turned to, how is this going to be marketed? How does a 5K be marketed in general? First of all, I'm a senior in high school, and I've barely tapped into my economic class, and I don't know what marketing is. I know about it. I know that there's commercials, and I know that there's billboards, but what's really going on? So I began to read this little book called Influence, Science and Practice by Robert Cialdini, and I learned a lot from it. I didn't read the whole book, but I read a lot of it, and there was some good tips in there to sell you something. I learned from the book about the click-whir response. This is a marketing aspect, an advertising technique used by marketers to market an event, market a product, using a person, a celebrity, if you will, a well-known person or a well-known fact. This is the click-whir response. But then there was also a big couple of chapters about influential jiu-jitsu, is what they called it, influential jiu-jitsu. This is where you have these sort of people selling you something. These sort of sellers are selling a product, and they know exactly which words to say. They know how to say it to get you to say yes. They are appealing to your, they're appealing to you psychologically, and this is what we call influential jiu-jitsu. But now I'm getting into a whole bunch of marketing aspects and advertising, and something just popped into my mind. I'm reading about this, and I think, well, I know a lot about this already because of the other industries that I'm familiar with as a high school student who are using these sort of techniques that I've already heard about, in the organization that I participate called One Life, One Goal, Teens Against Tobacco Initiative, where I attend meetings and have been a member for about 2.5 years now. So there are other industries that exploit the media and use it to their advantage. They are using this influential jujitsu, now that I know the terminology, to get their point across, and that one industry is one that is more dangerous and causes more deaths than alcohol, AIDS, car crashes, illegal drugs, murders, suicides, and homicides. That, ladies and gentlemen, is what we call the tobacco industry. Obviously, I feel very strongly about the tobacco industry because I do participate in the ACE After School program, One Life, One Goal, and I want to throw some facts out at you while you're sitting here that I decided I needed to use for my 5K in some way. I need to get the word out for something. So not so far, my 5K is a nonprofit 5K, but I know I want to make some kind of profit for something. But in Texas, on average, the tobacco industry spends more than $622.4 million on just advertising alone for their products. This is the state of Texas, ladies and gentlemen. And the youth in the state of Texas are 3 times more likely to be persuaded by these advertisements. They are everywhere. It's a billboard. It's in the stores. It's all outside on the buildings. It's on the ground, the cigarette butts. They're everywhere. And these youth that are 3 times more likely to be persuaded are always going to go for Marlboro, Camel, and Newport. These are the 3 most heavily advertised brands. And that's what we are saying. 81% of youth smokers are smoking these because they are the most heavily advertised. So they know that it is working. And the tobacco industry knows that you need marketing, because only 90% of all smokers start in their teen years. That's back to that 3% of young ones who are being advertised so much. And at this point, I need tobacco to be part. I need One Life to be a part of my 5K. Whatever way they're going to be, it's a danger, and it needs to be out into the community, especially the community in Maine. There's some things, events that we've already hosted, but why not host a bigger one? Let's do it. But what am I going to raise money for? I don't know. I participate in student council, NHS, the senior class president, band, track. Maybe we can make money for One Life, One Goal. We already know that One Life, One Goal is going to be involved in the 5K. And I decided, I had so much with prom last year, let's make a senior class fundraiser out of it. Yes, but why are you just going to give money to the senior class? They're seniors, they are already losing their abilities to go to school and pay attention in school, and we're giving them money. Yes, we're going off to college, but let's give them something to be excited about. Let's do something big. So automatically, I started learning more and more about Project Graduation. Project Graduation, for those of you who don't know, is the school-sponsored event that is held the night of our graduation when we graduate to keep us off the roads due to away from underage drinking, away from tobacco usage. Hello, ding, 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 ding. They're together, finally. Project Graduation is my click word response. It is my jujitsu. I have found what I'm going to start to sell. So these are just some facts. That the leading cause of deaths for 15 to 20-year-olds is in motor vehicle crashes. This is found from the Mothers Against Drunk Driving organization. This is a national organization, and I used a lot of their facts and research to back up 5K in order to get mainly sponsors. So how did the 5K come about? Well, I decided to go and talk to some